Coming up.
My heart began to rush.
Burned alive.
Like the trailer ignited in flames.
A meth head's brush with death.
Just let me die.
On the next 700 Club Interactive.
On 700 Club Interactive, we use technology to pray for each other and explore topics that matter to you. Watch what God is doing in the world today.
Hello and welcome to 700 Club Interactive. The TV series Breaking Bad is all about a chemistry teacher who is diagnosed with inoperable lung cancer, and he turns to a life of crime by producing and selling methamphetamine just to secure his family's financial future.
Well, Rodney Williams had no such altruistic motives for making his meth. He sacrificed his family and everything they owned in pursuit of the drug until the night it all backfired.
I'm in a small trailer cooking methamphetamines. The fumes had built up and a spark went off the heat lamp.
As a young man, Rodney Williams believed God had a plan for his life, but he wasn't sure he could carry it out, or even if he wanted to.
There was a battle going on, and I just felt like I wasn't strong enough to win that battle, and I kind of quit on God. I said, hey, I'll be back later. I'm going out kind of like the prodigal son. I'm going to sow my oats. I'm going to go out here and see the world, and when I'm strong enough, I'll come back.
By the time Rodney reached high school, he was an alcoholic and a drug addict, chasing his next high.
We began breaking into homes and getting alcohol and getting drunk. I was experimenting, trying all these different things that I thought would satisfy me, make me happy.
Rodney got a job and eventually married, but even the birth of his son didn't change his focus.
The money needed to be going towards my kid and the family. Instead, I'm spending it on my addiction. It was all about me, getting high, all about the addiction. Taking care of my God, which was the alcohol, the drugs, the gambling. It was all about that.
A short time later, Rodney's wife divorced him, and he tried to numb the pain he felt the only way he knew how.
As long as you stay high and over in this little world, everything's okay. You'll do whatever it takes to stay over in this little world because you don't want to go back over here, you know, and deal with life. The initial high is just awesome. Doesn't take long as you continue to try and do it. It begins to diminish, and before you know it, you're in this bondage where you're doing it just to function.
Rodney was with a friend one night when he was introduced to meth.
We're just riding around and snorting what we thought was cocaine, which was methamphetamines, and after snorting about an 8-ball, which is 3.5 grams, my heart began to rush, and man, just feel the blood just pumping through your veins.
His first experience with meth nearly killed him. The incident was one of over a dozen drug overdoses. Eventually, Rodney decided he needed help and went through rehab, but it didn't work. He even tried going back to church.
I even walked the aisle, prayed a prayer of repentance, but in reality, there was no heart change. I really was not prepared to give up the lifestyle that I was living.
Rodney's addiction soon consumed everything he had left.
I had a good government job. On the way home one day, I ain't going back there. I'm going to cook the methamphetamines and sell it. That was my mentality, and I lost my home. I was finding different places to go and to cook it. My last night as a drug addict, I'm high, I've been up for days. I'm in a small trailer, I'm paranoid. I got the doors bolted down in the trailer. I'm cooking methamphetamines, fumes are built up. And a spark went off the heat lamp, like the trailer ignited in flames. It was like I was surrounded. Couldn't get out because the door was locked. I began unlocking the doors and run outside on fire. And now I'm standing here at 2 o'clock in the morning, all burned up. I'm homeless, I've lost everything I've got. My family does not like me. I've burnt them so many times, I've done them so dirty.
Rodney stumbled to a neighboring house for help. As the people sped him to the hospital, he began to think about his life.
I was just miserable. Death would have been a victory at that time. I mean, I felt like, you know, just let me die. It was like the light turned on, you know. I remember the Lord that had comforted me as a child. And I turned to Him and cried out to God. I cried out to Jesus, cried out that He could take my eye, my ear, and whatever's left, I was going to serve Him. I made an unconditional surrender to the Lord Jesus Christ that night on the way to the hospital.
Rodney was in the hospital for weeks and underwent skin grafts for second and third degree burns. When he was released, he went back to rehab. But this time, things were different.
I'm reading the Bible, and the Bible's making sense. It's never made really sense to me before. All of a sudden, God's just showing me stuff through His Word. The Holy Spirit is showing me sin in my life. I'm confessing it and forsaking it, and He's just transforming me, changing me, renewing my mind, setting me free.
His recovery was not always easy, but Rodney says God helped him get through it.
Through a lot of my weak points, God has been there to protect me and carry me through, and I'm so thankful that He is God and that He does that.
Rodney went on to seminary and has been a pastor since 2006. He's now remarried and has a family.
I've got such a great life, not without struggles, by no means, but a great life compared to the bondage that I used to be in. God has proved faithful. When I did give it all to Him, it's a lot different from what I thought it was. The things that I was worried about, that I would be miserable, that I would not be happy, you know, giving all to Him, God has proved me wrong, you know, that I am happy, I've got joy. It's not what I thought it was going to be. It's great.
Rodney encourages others to trust God with their lives.
Many times I want to give Him a portion. I want to make deals with God. But when you're prepared to surrender all, give Him, just give Him your life. And God can take it, and He can change it, and He can give you a victory, you know, that you can never imagine.
He can give you a victory that you could never imagine. I think Rodney's idea about what it's like to be a Christian, what it's like to be in relationship with Jesus, it's like a lot of people. You think about all you have to give up, you know, all the good things you're going to miss out, all the good times you're going to, you know, not be part of. You're not going to be part of the in crowd anymore, all of those things. But Rodney's life, let it be an example for you. You know, if you think that the world has something to offer, and if you think that somehow taking drugs is going to make your life better, well, think again. You know, first you take the drug, and then the drug takes you. And it takes you places that you never thought you'd go, where, like Rodney, you can burn your family. You can burn up your life. All in the pursuit of a drug, all in the pursuit of alcohol, all in the pursuit of something. Now, for some of you, it's not drugs and alcohol. It's other things. Is it sex? Is it success? Is it money? Well, you need to know none of that will satisfy. The world makes lots of promises, but it never delivers. When Jesus makes a promise, He delivers. And His promise to you is righteousness, peace, and joy. The rules, if you will, aren't to keep you from good things. They're to keep you from some very bad things so that you can have success, not in the world's terms, but in terms that satisfy the inner longings of your heart. You're not giving up anything. You're getting life, and you're getting it more abundantly, and you're getting it for all eternity. So stop looking at the sacrifice and start looking at the joy set before you and how great that is and how wonderful that is. And then you start understanding, what will it profit a man if he gains the whole world and loses his own soul? And then you understand it's through giving away life that you get life eternal. So be like Rodney. Don't make bargains with God. Don't try to deal with God. Just surrender and say, I trust You. I trust in everything You want for me, and I give it all to You. I don't want to keep any of it back. I want all my life under your control, your direction. When you do that, that's when righteousness, peace, and joy come. So, if you want to try this, we're here for you. We're here for you 24 hours a day. You don't have to wait until you hit bottom. You can do it right now. Don't let another day go by. And you can call us, 888-777-1999. There's someone on the other end of that phone that's prayed the same prayer. All you have to say is, I want to find Jesus. I want to know him. I want to surrender my life to him. And if you're wondering, is it real? Is there really a God? Does he really care for me? Does he really love me? Here's the prayer for you. Jesus, if you're there, if you died for me, if you came for me, if you love me, if you're real, could you show me? Could you show up for me? Could you take my life and use it? And if you pray that with all of your heart, he'll answer. He'll come in. He'll show you the way. But make that call. Do it right now. 888-777-1999. Terry?
Coming up, a mother who risked everything to protect her family from her husband. Her story of survival is next, so don't go away.
He had all he ever wanted, and he still wanted more.
We had plenty of money, we had the right home, the right cars. I was very skilled at lying, and it was not a very large step for me to cross when it came to infidelity.
How he lost it all and gained it all back on today's 700 Club Interactive.
I was having some pains between my shoulder blades. At that point, everything changed. Diagnosis, pancreatic cancer. First, there was prayer. The second is to fight. As soon as we walked through those doors at Cancer Treatment Centers of America, all my anxiety left. The pastoral care here is based on the Bible, based on the Word of God, just as it is at our own church.
When you combine the great medicine with the spiritual resources we have, it provides the patients with something that really can make a difference.
You got a pastor right there on staff praying with patients, and whether it be scripture or whether it just be a word of encouragement to say God's got this.
If you or someone you love is fighting complex or advanced stage cancer, go to cancercenter.com/faith. You'll learn how our treatment results compare to national averages and see a list of insurance plans with which we've worked. Advanced medicine and technology, the warm embrace of the Spirit.
I firmly believe God led me here.
Call or go to cancercenter.com. Cancer Treatment Centers of America. Care that never quits. Appointments available now.
Come to the Holy Land and walk in the footsteps of Jesus. From Nazareth to the birthplace of his ministry, the shores of Galilee. Stand where he stood. Be baptized in the Jordan River. Hallelujah, he is everlasting. Ask your pastor or visit goisrael.com to learn more about making the journey that will transform your faith in God and his word. Experience Israel. You'll never be the same.
Inside of Armenia, drug use is on the rise, and so is the number of drug addicts. This epidemic is taking its toll on the country and tearing families there apart.
For years, Valley and her husband had a loving marriage. Then he had an affair in their home right in front of her. He drank and used drugs and physically abused her.
He didn't give us money for food, so we would often go hungry. He hit me often and would bang my head on the floor. Our daughter would cry, "Don't beat my mom." It was horrible.
Valley was abused so badly, she began to lose her eyesight. She feared for her daughter's life, so she packed their things and left.
I wasn't going to wait for him to hurt our daughter.
Valley couldn't find a job because of her vision. She and her daughter Sirenush couldn't even afford basic necessities. So they started getting food and clothing through an Orphan's Promise program for at-risk youth and families in need.
Every time they visited, they invited Sirenush to their center and invited both of us to church.
At the youth center, Sirenush studied English, learned computer skills, and heard about the love of Jesus Christ.
I learned that Jesus can still help people, so I asked him to help my mom and me.
Valia started going to church with Sirenush and gave her life to Christ. But without the ability to work, she was in danger of losing her daughter to social services. So Orphan's Promise took her to an eye clinic and paid for her surgery.
I couldn't believe that my dreams were finally coming true. I'd be able to see well again.
Soon after the surgery, Valia's eyesight was good enough to work again. She got a job as a cook and can now provide for herself and her daughter.
I have God in my heart. My eyesight was restored, and I have a job, all thanks to your help. Because of you, I can take care of my daughter and think about our future. I am very grateful.
You changed our lives. You helped both of us so much. Thank you.
You know, sometimes you find yourself in a desperate situation, so desperate that you can't see any hope anywhere. Orphan's Promise is coming into the lives of families like this little family in Armenia and saying, we want to keep you together. There are thousands of kids, hundreds of thousands of kids in orphanages, not because they're necessarily true orphans, but because their families have been broken up because of drugs, because of alcohol, because of poverty. Part of what we do is a project called Keeping Families Together. You make it possible for us to do that when you join the 700 Club. We want to thank you for your support of CBN's Orphan's Promise, Superbook, the other things that are happening around the world that are not just teaching children how to have hope and how to dream, but also teaching them about the incredible love of God and a Father who will never leave them. So join with us in bringing that truth and that message. Won't you join the 700 Club right now? 65 cents a day, $20 a month. That makes you a 700 Club member. And you can do that by going to your phone and calling 1-888-777-1999. Call now. We need to hear from you. And there are so many children waiting to have you come alongside of them and make a difference. Gordon?
And if you want to designate your gift to Orphan's Promise, you can do that easily just by going to cbn.com. And on the giving page, you can give directly to Orphan's Promise. And 100% of your gift will go into that work. So if you want to do that, just log on to cbn.com or just say when you call, I want to give to Orphan's Promise. Well, when we come back, a meth head's not-so-perfect plan to beat his drug addiction.
And took my wedding ring off and put it on the note and then took a .45 caliber pistol out on a ridge and I put the gun to my head.
Find out what stayed his hand and saved his life. That's up next.
God said to me, if you stay on this path that you're on, it'll bring death. He revealed the dark places of my heart. It's like my whole vision suddenly opened up. I knew at that point that I had been forgiven of all my sins. There is hope on the other side, and if you just keep pressing through and trusting Him, He will bring you out the other side.
If you're the mother of a child with behavior problems, I'd like to talk to you. My name is Janet Lehman, and I'm a behavioral therapist and a mom. I know what it's like when the child that you love becomes a defiant, out-of-control child who disrespects you.
That's why my husband James and I created the Total Transformation, the program that tens of thousands of moms are now using to turn around their child's behavior.
If you've heard about the Total Transformation and wondered if it will work for you, now you can try it for free. I'm willing to give away 1,000 programs today for free.
All you need to do is get the program and let us know how it works for you. We'll let you keep it for free.
I know the Total Transformation works because I used these techniques with my own son and with troubled kids for over 30 years. Let me prove to you that it works by giving you the program free.
Call the number on your screen now to get the Total Transformation free.
Counting blessings every day. Keeping focus won't go astray. Feeling strong and staying fit. Makes me smile at all my gifts. Here's to us who work so hard. Staying healthy on our guard. By my side is here you'll stay. It's a brand new world today.
Gen Strips, $9.95 for a box of 50.
For 8 minutes, Brandon Stearns was king of the world. At least that's how he felt after taking meth for the very first time. But soon those drugs ripped everything away from Brandon, and that's when he figured the only way to get the drugs out of his body was to put a bullet into his head.
I wrote a note to my wife that said, you know, tell Clayton I love him and I'm sorry. And took my wedding ring off and put it on the note and then took a 45 caliber pistol out on a ridge and I put the gun to my head.
Brandon Stearns was tired. Tired of his 8-year addiction to methamphetamines, of being arrested, and of letting his family down.
I just didn't want to live anymore.
Brandon grew up in a good family that attended church regularly. One day, on the way home from church, his mother stopped the car to have a heart-to-heart talk with her son.
We were driving down the road, and she was presenting, you know, the gospel to me. And it was that day, when I was 12 years old, that I asked Christ into my heart.
For a while, he grew in his faith, but later took a detour down some very dark roads. When he was 19, someone introduced him to meth.
Methamphetamine has about an 8-minute high that the person that takes it for the very first time, that they actually, they chase that 8-minute high the rest of their life. I mean, immediately it was nothing but a spiral downhill from that very point that I took that drug the first time.
His journey included arrests and several trips to the emergency room.
If it wasn't going into the hospital, I was on my way going to jail for possession of methamphetamine, for false information to police officers. Upon being arrested, I would be thrown in drug court programs or 30-day live-in programs. My parents spent $7,000 and took me down to a place down in Fresno to try to get me cleaned up, and nothing would ever be able to deliver me from the grip that methamphetamine had on my life.
Brandon almost died twice as a result of his drug abuse.
I had actually mixed some marijuana at one point in time with some methamphetamine and ended up smoking it, and I just had a bad reaction to it. I was told by the nurse that if you don't bear down and reset your heart, the blood pressure is 220 over 110, you're gonna have a heart attack. You're gonna code on this table.
During this time, Brandon met and married Sarah.
That world to me was so far off, it wasn't a reality to me. I didn't understand what the drug world was and what it entailed.
About 4 years, I drug her through just literal hell. And I would always lose my jobs. And I'd be gone 2 or 3 days at a time. They would come looking for me. I'd say I was going to help a friend put a stereo in. Next thing you know, I'm down in the valley picking up, you know, with somebody that's picking up a large amount of drugs.
I thought, you know, every time he told me, oh, I'm done, I'm sorry, you know, I believed him. And it became that codependent lifestyle.
Eventually, Brandon lost hope and decided to kill himself.
I just began to think about my mom finding me out there, and that being the last thing that my mom saw was her son with his head blown off sitting on the end of the ridge, and I just couldn't do it. I broke down and started crying.
Brandon was put on the county's most wanted list for grand theft auto, possession, and burglary, all stemming from his meth addiction.
I was running for about 6 days. It was time. God would not let me go. I mean, everywhere I went, their house was getting raided, a business was being raided. Every time I would leave a place, the police were hitting the place within minutes.
Brandon was riding in a friend's car when he noticed red lights flashing behind him.
They surrounded the car that I was in, and so I just took the last cigarette that I had actually smoked out of my mouth and put it on the ground, and they threw me in the police car. And that day on that road, I just leaned my head against the cop car window and I said, Lord, I don't want to be this person anymore. This is not what I want to be, and I need you to change me.
Brandon was convicted and sentenced to 4 years in jail. While he was there, Sarah filed for divorce.
It was 4 years of empty promises, and when I went to prison, that was it. It was over. Nobody in her right mind can stay with somebody like that. It was absolutely a horrible time of my life.
One night, Brandon had a vision from God.
I saw somebody standing in front of me with their back turned to me, and I could only see from the shoulders down, and it looked like an older brown type of garment. And a hand reached back and motioned me with his fingers and said, follow me, follow me. And he said that 3 times, and I took a step to follow him, and then the vision ended.
In that moment, Brandon dedicated his life to Christ.
And so I chose to follow after the Lord and just dig in his word and just seek after him like I've never sought after anything in my life.
Brandon was released after just 3 years and found some strong Christian men to mentor him.
I'm just absolutely blown away at the work that the Lord has done in a little over 9 years of my life. 36 months of that was in prison.
Brandon and Sarah later reconciled and remarried, and Sarah became a Christian when she saw the change in Brandon. Today, he is the pastor of a growing church in California and finally knows what it really means to be free.
Jesus is the key that unlocks every door. He's the deliverer. He's the strong tower. He's the comforter. He's the keeper of his people. He's the Son of the living God. He's God in the flesh, and he is absolutely everything. Doesn't matter how far you've gone, how long you've been there. If you call out to God, no matter where you're at, he will answer you. God is never so far away that you can't find him or you can't call to him.
Brandon's story is hardly unique. Here's what one of our friends on Facebook said. I was addicted to meth and dealing $30,000 worth of drugs every week. I thought I had the world by the tail, but it had me by the neck until Jesus got me by my heart. Praise God, I'm now saved. Well, sadly, there are still millions of others who are trapped in their addictions. Cynthia writes, please include in your prayers my friend Eric, who is jobless and is into drug using and pushing.
Let's pray for people who are trapped in this. If you're not, you probably know somebody who is. Maybe they're a family member. And if they are a family member, you're going through it with them, whether you realize it or not, whether their behavior is affecting you. And let's just pray for you. Let's pray for them. And let's pray for addiction to be broken in their lives. Mm-hmm. Pray with us. Lord, we lift up those who are in the shackles of addiction, whose hearts are enslaved to drugs and alcohol, and we just break that over them now in Jesus' name. And Lord, we ask that you take their hearts and reform them so they no longer love the thing that's killing them, but they would love you, the giver of life. So be with them. We ask that you would send messengers after your own heart to them that would share with them the good news, that would love them, not judge them, not condemn them, but love them and let them know that you love them too. And now for friends and family members who are suffering their own consequences from loved ones who are addicted, be with them, comfort them. Let them know that you are the answer to their need and supply all their needs, supply their finances, give them security, and most of all, Lord, give them peace of mind that you have their future. We ask it all in Jesus' name. Amen. If you need prayer, we're here for you. All you have to do is call us, and we're here for you 24 hours a day. And if you're suffering with addiction and you just want someone to pray you through a craving, we're here for you. All you have to do is call us. 888-777-1999. Terry?
Well, we have some questions from our inbox. Susan says, my son has been a crack addict for about 10 years. He would rather live on the streets than try to stop. As a mother, I'm torn between being broken for him and so angry that I don't want anything to do with him. Am I wrong for feeling this way? And then in box number two is Sharon, who says, my husband is a recovering drug addict. He says he can watch a TV commercial and have it trigger his desires. Sometimes he leaves after that, and I don't see him for days. I can tell he wants to resist. Still, we have young children that I have to protect from his behavior. Do I make him leave?
I'm not going to tell you to make him leave. You've got to come to that own conclusion. For both these questions, you're dealing with the consequences of addiction in your own life. And all the emotional turmoil you're feeling is normal. I would encourage you to get into a support group with other family members of addicts. They're available. Al-Anon is one of the leaders. And just you need someone to try to walk through. For the mother, look at the story of the prodigal, where the father lets the prodigal go and then waits for him to return. That could be an inspiration to you. We leave you this word from Peter, cast all your anxiety on him because he cares for you. God bless you.